basically, this use case is a farmer, like this one we have here, which is Tyrion Lannister. And Tyrion Lannister needs a new loan for buy two new trucks, right? And we have another farmer, which is Sansa Stark. And Sansa needs the loan to build a new barn. So basically, they're going to fight each other to conquer the whole Westeros and all the farms. But before that, they need to apply for funds on the central bank. So that's basically our use case. So the farmers that need to request the loan through this application, and the process to get this is the process we're going to demo. So like I said, we're not going to focus in an UI part of this process. We're going to just demo the backend. But the JBPM key server is easily attached to any UI. So any like Node.js, any JavaScript UI you have, Angular, anything like mobile apps, anything you can create it there, and then you can connect with the JBPM key server because it's all REST APIs being exposed. We're going to have the JBPM key server has its own database, which we, in this demo we use Postgres, and they're going to be integrated with Kafka Stream using StreamZ for the operator to deploy on OpenShift, and a Kafka bridge, which is going to be the bridge with the consumer going to read, prepare the data, and save on the InfluxDB. And then the analysis tool is Grafana, which connects to InfluxDB through a data source here. So first, I'm going to start the Java process that's going to kick off the process and generate some tasks. So it's just going to put 30, and then you're going to generate 30 process that's going to be running. Let me just press start, and then he's starting creating. So the tasks that you see is just a counter. So it's not the task IDs like some people are familiarized, like task IDs or process instances. We're not displaying this, that. It's just displaying that we're sending post requests to kick off the process. And you, as you can see, all the pending stages are starting showing up on the graph. Because if you go back here to the process, if you guys remember the first part of the process, he published pending states on Kafka. Kafka had been reading by the consumer. Consumer put the information on InfluxDB. Then the Grafana is already pulling this information out and put there. So we are stopping there in the claim found approval task. So now we need to approve or reject. So we have another process that we're going to start moving this pending process across. And so to move that, we have another Java process we want to run, which is the task automator. So we run that, and he's going to start collecting the first 10 tasks, and then randomly decide if it's approval or reject, right? So if you just press the start, and then you can see he collected the first task, and then you can see the first 10 task IDs, and then he claimed the tasks, and then he's gonna start that tasks and complete all the tasks. So a few of these tasks gonna be approval, a few gonna be rejected. So let's check how this affect our charts. So you can see he randomly pick up some of these tasks and start approving reject, and you can start seeing the graph keep showing, increasing of the use of the budget,